You want a simple yet elegant Passover dinner menu? You are at the right place. In this video, I will share with you 5 foolproof recipes for the perfect Passover dinner menu, including the best Passover brisket recipe, a delicious potato kugel for Passover, 2 side dishes, and the most stunning Passover dessert, a chocolate cloud cake. And if you like this kind of content, all about simplifying yet leading a more meaningful Jewish life, please consider subscribing. So let's jump into it. In a bowl, whisk the thyme with the paprika, the sage, the ground pepper, and 1 tablespoon of sea salt. Rub the spice mixture all over the brisket and let stand at room temperature for 1 hour. Place a 9x13 baking dish or pan in the oven and preheat your oven to 400 degrees Fahrenheit, letting the dish heat up inside. Peel the potatoes, then use a food processor or a hand grater to grate them into large shreds. Meanwhile, peel and shred the 2 large onions in the food processor or with a hand grater and put it aside. In a medium mixing bowl, whisk together the eggs, the salt, the pepper until fluffy. Drain the potato shreds in a clean towel, twisting the towel, pushing out the excess liquid. And if you own a potato ricer, it is a great way as well to remove the excess water. Place the grated potatoes in a large bowl, add the seasoned eggs, grated onions, and potato starch to the bowl and mix. Take the preheated baking dish out of the oven. Quickly pour the olive oil and spread the oil around the bottom and sides of the hot dish. Carefully and quickly spread the potato mix into an even layer in the baking dish. It should sizzle. Then drizzle the remaining tablespoon of olive oil across the top. Bake uncovered for 60 to 70 minutes until the top is nicely browned. In a large flame-proof roasting pan set over 2 burners, heat the oil. Add the brisket to the roasting pan and cook over moderately high heat, turning it once until browned. Transfer the brisket to a large baking sheet. Add the onions and a generous pinch of salt to the roasting pan. Cook over moderate heat, stirring occasionally, until the onions are softened and well browned, about 20 minutes. Add the beef stock, the vinegar, the tomato puree, the garlic, the peppercorns, and bay leaf and bring to a simmer. Return the brisket to the roasting pan. Tent the brisket with foil. Bake for about 6.5 hours until very tender. Transfer the brisket to a carving board, then tent with foil and let rest for about 20 minutes. Place water at the bottom of a steamer pan set, add the salt and margarine and bring to a boil. Trim the dry ends of the asparagus. If the spears are thick, peel them lightly with a vegetable peeler. Place them in the top half of the steamer pan set. Steam for about 5 to 10 minutes depending on the thickness of the asparagus or until the asparagus is tender. To accompany the juices from the Passover brisket, we need some mashed potatoes. So mash your potatoes and then you're gonna add a bit of margarine, a bit of plant-based milk, some salt, some garlic, and you're ready to go. Combine the chocolate, the oil, 1/2 cup of margarine in a large heat-proof bowl set over a saucepan of simmering water. Stir often until melted. Remove the bowl from the saucepan and separate 4 eggs, placing whites and yolks in separate medium bowls. Add cocoa powder, vanilla, salt, 1/4 cup of sugar, and the remaining 2 eggs to the bowl with the yolks and whisk until the mixture is smooth. Gradually whisk the yolk mixture into the chocolate mixture, blending well. Using an electric mixer on high speed, beat the egg whites until frothy. With the mixer running, gradually beat 1/2 cup of sugar and beat until soft peaks form. Gently fold the egg whites into the chocolate mixture in 2 additions, folding just until incorporated between additions. Scrape the batter into the prepared pan, smooth the top, and sprinkle with the remaining 2 tablespoons of sugar. Transfer to a wire rack and let the cake cool completely in the pan. The cake will collapse in the center and crack further as it cools. For the topping, using an electric mixer on medium-high speed, beat the cream and the powdered sugar in a medium bowl until firm peaks form. Mount the whipped cream mixture in the center of the cake, top it with chocolate shavings or some fresh fruits, and finally remove the sides of the springform pan from the cake. It's finally time to reveal the brisket, carve the brisket, and transfer to a platter. Serve with the pan juice and vegetables. And there you have it, a complete Passover dinner menu with the main course, the side dish, and the dessert. I hope that this video was useful for you. I encourage you to watch these two videos as a follow-up. And if you like this kind of content, all about simplifying yet leading a more meaningful Jewish life, please consider subscribing. Until next time, stay safe, stay blessed, and don't forget to frum it up.